Good afternoon. This is Rob at Next Truck Sales. I want to introduce you to our 2015 Kenworth T680. It has a PACCAR MX13 at 485 horse, 1650 torque, a 13-speed manual transmission, all-wheel disc brakes, workstation, Vantage interior, and the beautiful 7-spoke Kenworth wheels. I'll take you for a quick walk around the truck. If you could look, we've got multiple units like this available. I'd say at this point we probably have 5 or 6. They all have low profile virgin drives. This one here is a Continental. And they all have sliding fifth wheels, Holland FW35 sliding fifth wheels. They've got, what size is the tank here? This side here is 120 gallon. I'll get you a look at the disc brakes back here. Okay. Now, this particular truck has a rusty pot. We have sent out the majority of the trucks to have, be sandblasted and painted. If you look through the listing, you're going to see the one truck that I put up has had the frame painted, and all of our trucks will be painted by the time that this listing gets posted up on the internet. Okay, these came from a large fleet and they're fleet maintained. They'll all come with virgin tires, at least 50% tread. They're all going to come with cold air conditioning, no check engine lights, and no major oil leaks. They all look the same. They're all sequential serial numbers. I'm gonna pop up the hood. Hopefully it's open on the other side. Yes, it is. Okay. They all have spring front suspension, and you'll see here the Packer engine is actually quite good for not leaking oil. Some of the issues that we have experienced, like in the case of this one, is the back pressure valve, which is that unit here. In this case, it was replaced. It's not a cheap proposition. We are selling the trucks with no check engine lights and no oil leaks, so if something like that causes a check engine light, we're replacing it. Okay. They'll all be hooked up and we'll run a regen, make sure that they'll complete a successful regen. The emission systems will be connected and working. Okay, part of our get ready also includes a grease job, an oil change, changing the filters, new wiper blades, a fresh DOT. If you look here, this one was done November 2020. Okay, no major body damage. I'll take you on the inside on this one in a minute. I'll just get you a quick look on the inside here. Okay, so this one here has a subwoofer. That's a stereo subwoofer, and it had, these units all had APU units. They do not anymore. I'll take you quickly across here to give you a quick look. There was an APU there, it's been removed. So low idle time, but no APU on these. And this other tank is also 120, so 240 gallons total fuel capacity. I'll go on the inside and have a look at the nice interior. This is one of my favorite trucks. It's one of the nicest interiors. This is the Vantage trim level. It doesn't have the button tuck, but it does have the stitching. Power locks, mirrors, windows, heated mirrors as well. I'm gonna fire this one up. Take the seat cover off. These, we have all of our upholstery is shampooed, and so this is left behind because the seat will often be wet. Everybody likes it. Wet, hiney. Now, it has a full gauge package. It does not have the GPS. None of these units have GPS, and that's a good and a bad thing. And the reason why I say it's a good thing is because those units are crazy expensive to replace. We had to buy one on another unit, and it was the tune of about $6,000 by the time everything was said and done. This one does have Bluetooth audio. It does have automatic climate control. So it'll give you automatic, just like in your car. We've got full gauges here, and we've got plenty more gauges here. The one that I like the best is your amperage. It tells you the state of the battery, boost pressure, oil temp, front and rear drive axles, trailer brake application, trans temp air filter restriction, trailer air pressure, fuel filter restriction, and the clock, which is an analog clock, is a rare thing to see in a truck nowadays. Over here we've got your switch for your bunk, which I'll take you back there in just a moment. There's a two position switch here. The first click gives us nice mood lighting on the floor. The second click turns on the interior lights overhead. And we've got a nice feature, which is an exterior light test. When I push this, we get exterior light test in process, and you can go out and check all the lights, and it'll turn on the high beams and turn on the low beams and turn on all the signals. So that's nice. And then this is your dimmer for your dash. So you adjust that there with this switch. And then you've got your work lights are here. You've got tilt and telescoping steering wheel. I'm just gonna push this out of the way a little bit. This one here, what else have we got? Engine fan override, which is always nice. Your cruise control, which is here. You've got your engine brake, your regen, disable. You got differential lock, sliding fifth wheel, and suspension. Headlights are here. These are HID headlamps. So these headlamps will light up the street nice and bright, so you're not going to have to look to upgrade them. And then you've got your parking lamps, and that'll flash your trailer. We'll leave those off for now, and I'll take you in the back. So this is the Vantage interior. One of the nice features that I like on the 680 is the fridge switch. There's actually an external switch for the refrigerator, so we can turn on that fridge there. And if we turn off the key and we've left the fridge on, and I'll do that now, so I turned on the fridge and I turn off the truck, we get a little green light that says, hey buddy, you left your fridge on, so you're not coming back to flat batteries. We've got interior lighting here, three-way switch for the upper bunk lights. One is over there and one is over here. We've got more mood lighting. This little button here turns on that cute little red light to give you a little bit of illumination in the back. And we've also got another additional lamp, which will give you that much more lighting. Now we've got a flat screen TV mount, as well as a seat belt to hold in your cable box or DVD player. We've got a microwave strap here, and also got some more secure storage. In this case, we've got all the books are inside of here. One other thing I really do like about this is this little folding table. So the way this works, I've never seen one of these. 780s have them, but it's a little slightly different setup. This table spins around like that. And then I'm gonna try and do it with the phone in my hand here. You're gonna bring this little handle here, pull it back, slide the seat. I'm gonna put the phone down for half a second. So I've just slid the seat forward slightly. You can see that. And then I grab the handle, and this chair will spin. I might need to put it a little farther forward, but let's see if I can get it to go. Come forward a little more. And the chair spins right around. And then you've got yourself a nice table to eat or do a report, and very comfortable, and it's not really taking up a lot of extra room in the cab. So I'll give you a good wide angle shot of that. Okay, now also underneath the bunk here, in order to put the bed up, this table needs to be spun around. So I'm going to just put that up for you here now and get you a good look underneath. This is a 76-inch sleeper cab. So this is 1 inch off of the 780, which is one of the larger sleepers. It's very wide. The mattresses, if you compare the width of the mattresses in this truck compared to the Cascadia, it's about 4 inches wider than the Cascadia. So you can see everything's nice and clean. The truck's been fully detailed. We've also got refrigerator, as I'd shown you the switch for. And the nice feature on this one here, not sure why that's sticking, is the switch to turn it on. So you know when it's on because you've got a light. And this one is a decent fridge. I would say 9 out of 10 of these fridges are working, whereas in a lot of other manufacturers at this age, 9 out of 10 of them are broken. I'll take you over here too. We've got an emergency access door. So this opens up. But also, this window, this is like a little curtain here. We can just take that and it rolls up. And you've got that'll clip. Those clips will clip onto those clips once you roll it up. I'm not going to bother during the video to do that. We've got a second emergency access door. So that's a really nice feature for throwing gear in, clothing, a suitcase, whatever it is you happen to be packing. Or sometimes you run across something large that you want to throw in that isn't going to go in the back of your trailer. It'll go in there. And we've got the second bed. And you'll notice this mattress is in a plastic bag because it's brand new. All of the trucks that we sell come with brand new mattresses. And we've also got a brand new mattress in a bag up top here. Okay. Looking down from above, we've got another heater vent. We've got more lights. We've got secure storage up here. This is nice. And no shortage of storage in this truck. I'll give you a good wide angle perspective. So there you have it. So if you're interested in this truck or one of the other trucks that we have for sale that are very similar, like I said, we've probably got 5 or 6 of these available at this moment. Hop onto our website. Actually, if you're looking at this, you'll be on our website already. You just want to look at all of our T680s that we have for sale. And then pick one out. If it's on the website, it's available for sale. And our number is 844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-844-